Hi, my name is Russell Hillier from AtlasRFIDStore.com, and today we're going to walk through all the steps that are involved in unboxing and setting up the Alien F800 UHF RFID reader using a PoE injector. First, we're going to set up all the hardware pieces that you will need, and then in the next video, we're going to download the Alien Gateway program and set up our PC or laptop to connect to the reader. In order to read and write tags with the Alien F800 reader, you will need the following items.
The Alien F800 4-port UHF RFID reader, a PoE injector, a UHF RFID antenna like the MTI MT242043, an RP-TNC mail to RP-TNC mail cable, two standard Ethernet cables, and a sample pack of RFID tags. First, connect your reader to the UHF RFID antenna by using the RP-TNC mail to RP-TNC mail antenna cable. It is important that your antenna cable has the correct connectors for the reader and the antenna that you're using. This MTI MT242043 antenna has an RP-TNC female connector. Connect one end of the RP-TNC mail cable to the reader, and then connect the other end to the antenna. Next, you will want to connect your F800 reader to your PoE injector using the Ethernet cable. Connect one end of the Ethernet cable into the LAN PoE port on the reader, and then connect the other end into the out port on your PoE injector. Next, take the second Ethernet cable and plug it into the PoE injector's in port, and then connect the other end of the cable into your computer's Ethernet port. Next, plug in your PoE injector into a standard electrical outlet. After a few seconds, your F800's power light should turn on. Additionally, the LAN port on the reader should light up green in two places surrounding the Ethernet cable.
That concludes our video on unboxing and setting up the Alien F800 UHF RFID reader. Be sure to watch the next video in the series, installing the Alien Gateway and connecting to your F800 reader via PoE or LAN. Thanks for taking the time to walk through these steps with us. For more information on all things RFID, check out our blog, our RFID Resources page, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And as always, if you have any questions at all, please send us an email or give us a call.